Hello once again. Europound is the next opportunity which we're going to discuss for today. It starts from the daily chart. We're familiar with the current situation, of course, for those of you trading the Forex. It's been extremely exhausted in the last few weeks, I would say. Divergence is bearish pressure is there, and this is where it starts to become interesting, guys. So on the 4-hour chart, and we're going to start vice versa here, we're going to start with the warning signs or question marks. The only thing we couldn't get for this setup is the break below in order to create the convergence. Basically, we're looking for the reversal pattern that will trigger the sell opportunities for us. So based on the 4-hour chart, there was no convergence, and also there was no divergence before that. So this is the tricky part, but follow me here, bear with me, and you'll see what's my idea. When we drop to the 1-hour chart, we're going to find impulsive move. We're also going to find that the 090 zone right here is an extremely good resistance zone. And we're also going to find that we're currently creating a possible bounce off of this level. That level, guess what Fibo zone is meeting there? It means the Fibo 50 retracement. Plus, being a psychological round number, it is definitely a good place to look for possible sells, even based on divergences, which is the more aggressive idea. 061.8 right here, that level should remain intact. Basically, this is our invalidation or conservative protection. Of course, given that we are not going to create the divergence and it will continue going higher, this is where invalidation for me would be triggered and no more sells. So multiple ways to go ahead and enter this setup. Of course, the most aggressive but most rewarding one would be based on divergences. If we get the tick down and that divergence is completed here, I will be attacking based on the divergence plus candle pattern. Then we have trend line breakouts. Then we have the most conservative one, which is going to be this divergence completes itself and we get the breakout below that level for the sells. Of course, there is always a trade-off. If you're attacking here, then the risk reward is much better. If you're attacking here, then your entry is more conservative, okay? In case something like this happens, you're not going to lose money, but you're giving away pips, potential profits, right? So that's basically the setup, looking for these opportunities. Once again, we do have a few question marks on the way. So in my opinion, it should be treated at most as moderate setup here. That means lower risk, and don't go ahead and do crazy things with your risk management. If you have any questions, guys, leave them below and I'll reply. Thank you for watching.